Hi, I'm the poor student, and today we're going to be riding from point A to point B from MIT to Harvard. Right now, we're crossing the Harvard Bridge, which links Back Bay to Cambridge. MIT and Harvard are actually in Cambridge, and not Boston. As we're approaching the end of the bridge here, if you turn right or left, you'll be on Memorial Drive. However, we are not turning right or left, we are continuing straight on Massachusetts Avenue, or Mass Ave as the locals call it. So right now we're in MIT territory. If you've seen my previous video of the ride from Jamaica Plain to Cambridge, this footage will look quite familiar. But for today, we're going to be splicing two rides together so that you can see what it looks like to go from Harvard Bridge all the way up to Harvard on one road, Mass Ave. So we've passed the building that a lot of tourists like to take pictures in front of, you know, the building with the big pillars, and we're eventually going to be out of MIT territory. I'm not really sure where it ends, because MIT is a really big school, but if you turn right on Vassar Street, you'll see all the great buildings that have the unique-looking architectural features. If you turn right on Vassar Street, which is at the next set of lights up ahead. Okay, so if you want to see the other buildings of MIT, you turn right here. And this is where I spliced the clip, as you can see, because the weather changes dramatically here. So we're continuing straight on Mass Ave, and we just passed a bunch of railroad tracks. I'm not sure if there's an actual train that travels along there, but they look kind of neat. Okay, so the next place that we're going to see is Central Square. Now before we get there, we're going to pass by a couple more MIT buildings. So the MIT territory hasn't really ended quite yet. I think it ends at around Central Square. But on the right, I think this is the MIT Museum. So if the weather's not so good outside or something, you might want to just go in there and, you know, see what they're showing you. Okay, so coming up on the right is some kind of Greek fraternity house, perhaps, or something like that. And I think this is about where MIT territory ends. I think there might be a few more buildings on the left if you turn left back there. And this is basically Central Square. This is kind of a place where you can have a meal at a restaurant. Like, there's some Indian places here, there's McDonald's on the right, as you see here. Boomerang's, one of my favorite thrift stores that originated in Jamaica Plain, has recently opened a branch here. It's somewhere on the right. Oh, Mary Chung's on the left, that's the place with the green sign a few steps back. That's a really great Chinese restaurant, actually. People's United Bank has opened several branches in the Boston area, and there was one on the right corner there. There's a Goodwill store for more thrifting, if you like. Since this is the Poor Students channel, I feel the need to point things like that out. There's a Citibank on the right. And, oh, there's a great Indian restaurant. It's not really a restaurant. It's a supermarket plus takeout Indian place. It's called Shalimar, and it was back there on the right. And if you see the red sign on the left and on the right here, that's the Central Square T stop on the red line. So if you want to take public transportation here, you take the red line going north and get off at Central Station, Central Square Station. So we're passing Prospect Street. If you turn right there, you'll hit Broadway, which is another big street for restaurants and things in the Cambridge area. On the left, that big white building is the post office. It's a very big post office. About now, we're leaving Central Square. The rest of the stuff between here and Harvard is not really much to look at. There's some houses and things. The People's Republic is coming up on the left. That's the red building. The distance between MIT and Harvard is actually not very far. You could probably walk from MIT to Harvard if you have the time. Otherwise, you would just take the red line from Central Square station or Kendall station if you're coming from MIT. To go to Harvard, you get off at the Harvard Square station. If you're coming from Back Bay, you can just take the number one bus that goes up Mass Ave and it'll stop at Harvard Square. Okay, so a lot of these buildings are stores like Crate and Barrel you see on the right. There's a bunch of furniture stores on the left as well. I'm not sure why there are so many furniture stores in this particular area that we're in right now. But if you're looking for that kind of thing, this is where you'd go. Unfortunately, it'll probably cost you a lot of money. So you might want to check out the Goodwill and Boomerangs back in Central Square first. Okay, so there's some restaurants on the right. I think one of them is a seafood restaurant. Of course, if you're in Boston, you probably want to, you know, have some seafood before you leave, assuming you're not allergic to any of it. And on the left, there's a bunch of little stores. And as you can see on the right, that's some kind of Harvard hotel. And now we are in Harvard Square. On the right, that's what you call Harvard Yard. That's like the big quad with a lot of classroom buildings and stuff like that. And some dorms are in Harvard Yard as well. On the left are a bunch of restaurants like J.P. Licks, recently opened here. One of the entrances to Harvard Yard is on the right here. On the left, coming up, is the Holyoke Center. There's a great pizza place called Aji Gourmet. I like to buy my pizza dough from that place because they make the best dough in the world. Okay, so we're continuing out on Mass Ave, and this is where Mass Ave gets really confusing. Now, what I was trying to do was to get on the street that you see on the left there, but you can't just turn left here. You're not allowed to just cross traffic like that. So you actually have to go around this rotary that we're approaching. And of course, I'm in the wrong lane. Oh yeah, by the way, on the right, that's the Harvard Square T station, if you want to take transportation here on the red line. So of course, I'm in the wrong lane here, and I have to get into the left lane somehow. And it's a Sunday, so people are usually friendlier on the road on Sundays. And most people don't know where they're going on Sundays for some reason, too. So, if you're riding around on Sundays, it's pretty good. And, of course, you see the tourists on the right taking pictures of Harvard Yard, because it's also a tourist destination. Okay, so here I'm trying to get around this this greenish rotary type of thing on the left. So if you want to go around, make sure you're in the left lane, because if you're in the right lane, you're expected to go straight forward on Massachusetts Avenue. So if you want to get up to Davis Square, Porter Square, you would try to get into the right lane here and continue past the lights. However, I'm trying to get to Brattle Street, which was behind us here, and so you gotta wait for the light and turn left here and watch the buses coming out on the left. They're kind of underground there. And here I want to get into either this lane or the right lane. If you're in the left lane, you're going to go around the rotary again, which I did not want to do. So here I'm in the left lane, but I actually should be on the right lane because I want to make a right turn onto Church Street, which leads to Brattle Street. So fortunately, people are pretty friendly on the road on Sundays. And so here I'm turning right onto Church Street, which is a very, very small street. And there's a movie theater on the left. There's a place called Mint Julep back on the corner there. On the right is some kind of church. On the left, that's called the Border Cafe, which is a Tex-Mex place. Very reasonably priced. A lot of students go there. I heard the margaritas are good, but I don't drink margaritas. On the right, that's some kind of computer lab. So if you're a Harvard Extension School student, I think you get to use that lab. And here is Brattle Street, and I'm trying to turn right here. And of course, this being Sunday, there are a lot of Sunday drivers. Like this black car that's coming up on the left here, I'm thinking, are you gonna go? Are you gonna go? No. They just stopped there. Okay. So I'm turning right here. On the right is the Harvard Extension School building, and then the Harvard Graduate School of Education. Back on the left, I forgot to point out, that's Burdick's. It's the best chocolate place in town. Seriously, you gotta try it. Anyway, this is the end of the tour. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.